Fuck, come on, wait. Come on. Jay's lost, sorry. Welcome back, everybody. It's your boy JPEEZY. I apologize for the layoff last week. I wasn't home, didn't have time to film, and it's been a really crazy, weird time trying to get back into the swing of things with a lot of things reopening now. Like I told y'all in the first video coming back for whoever's seen it, I am trying to be transparent. Last week was just a hiccup, won't be a regular thing. Trying to make sure that I stay on par, but also not trying to rush anything. So it's still finding that balance, I guess. But we're not here to talk about that. We're here to talk about the fact that Marvel, just a few days ago, dropped the new trailer for their animated series coming up in August called What If? For those of you who don't know, it's gonna be an animated series about switching up things that happen in the MCU or different dimensions, and basically saying, what if something was different and how would that play out in that version of the MCU. Now, if you haven't seen the trailer yet, I highly recommend you go see it. This one was even better than the last ones that I've seen, so I'm really excited that they dropped this one. Even though I don't like watching too many trailers before something coming out, I'm definitely excited that I watched this one. So today, we're gonna get into what we saw from the trailer, what I hope is coming from this show as a whole, and why I believe this is gonna be the best Marvel Disney Plus series yet. And without further ado, me talking about this and that, let's get into it. So starting off with what we got in the trailer, I was so blown away by the first scene of it because it was one of the episodes I wasn't expecting to happen, and I never put two and two together. So it starts off with Tony Stark in the very first scene of Iron Man 1, where the armored vehicle he's in gets through the bombing area in the desert. He has to try and call in backup, the missile comes, and out of nowhere, Killmonger shows up and throws the missile away. And mans were sitting back in the chair like, so hooked right off the rip. It only reignited why I know this show is gonna be the best. So after that opening moment, we got a lot of looks at other things. Stuff that we already knew was coming, like T'Challa as Star-Lord now, more of Doctor Strange and what looks like a fight versus the Ancient One. We got more of Marvel Zombies, and we got more of Captain Carter. But this trailer also brought us some really small, quick glimpses at stuff that we weren't even sure was coming or not really sure where it's gonna fall in these episodes, and that included Thor, a look at Spidey, we got a moment of Hulk throwing some stuff around, and then two of the things that I saw that really blew me away was a quick glimpse at Vision taking the Mind Stone out of his own head or somebody else doing it that wasn't Thanos, and Gamora, who might be taking on the Thanos role in her episode of becoming the Mad Titan, trying to collect the Infinity Stones and taking over the universe. And after that incredible trailer, I also realized that Disney posted a new poster. Posted the poster. Post, post. A lot of posts. And this new poster just showed a bunch of different stuff in kind of like a circle-ish kind of pattern. And we saw the main characters in what's gonna be probably each episode. So we saw Captain Carter, we saw Gamora, we saw T'Challa, but we also saw something really interesting, which was Spider-Man in the top corner with the cloak of levitation on him, which I wonder if it's gonna be either Peter Parker becomes Spider-Man and the Sorcerer Supreme, or is it just that the cloak finds him and maybe he has to learn how to use it or something? I'm not sure. And we got what looks like Vision in Ultron's body, but with all six Infinity Stones in his chest. And I'm like, talk about OP, like who's supposed to stop that man? But I'm very certain that I think I know what happens there. So it was a couple days before Marvel posted the trailer that I saw a leaked look of a Funko Pop that I thought was just a fan make, but it's turned out to be real when they announced the What If Pops that are coming out. And it's Killmonger in a Black Panther suit, but with Ultron's head in his hand and a spear. And people are thinking, because we got a look of Killmonger in Wakanda fighting something, my theory is that it's Ultron, or Vision Ultron, or whatever they're gonna call him, trying to take over Wakanda and maybe using that land as what Ultron did in Age of Ultron to throw Sokovia back down in the earth to explode it. I think maybe it's Wakanda this time, and maybe Killmonger is the ruler of Wakanda, or maybe he's, I don't know, just the main warrior there, like the head of the Dora Milaje. So maybe that means that he's trying to defend it from Ultron and they have a battle. Maybe that's why the Funko was made, or maybe it's just something cool. I don't know. That's my theory, but we'll see. But that Vision look of him and with the Infinity Stones caught me super off guard. But as you can see, there is so much that is already being seen as stuff that's good we're gonna get in this first season of the show, and I'm super excited for everything because I just know it's gonna be the best, and I know it's gonna give us something so different. I'm also a huge fan of Jeffrey Wright's voice as the Watcher. I think it's gonna be great. He has so much gravitas, and I think it's gonna be really interesting to see his commentary. See something that you use these for. Listening to him speak on what's happening in the multiverse. And watching this only reminded me that there's so many opportunities and possibilities with a show like this that's just built off of the one question, which is what if. And it makes me wonder what else they're thinking of, because I think this show could go on for a super long time, which excites me because there's so many ideas to go off of. Not only do we have stuff that's happened already in the MCU that can be twisted, and we're gonna get some of that in the show, we can also get stuff that maybe down the line they're gonna try and test the waters in this show and maybe slowly bring it into the movies. Like stuff they're a little too scared to put to live action right away. And you know, it got me thinking, like, what if there were already characters that have a really good following and fan base to them, but that Marvel hasn't been able to bring into the movies? So they're wondering, you know, how can we bring these characters? Can we see if they're still popular? How would they work? Maybe those voice actors want to do something small and just kind of minute. I don't know, maybe there's some people that really deserve a spot in even something like this before they get to the MCU. Look, if you don't like that there's possibly going to be a Daredevil reference at every turn of this channel, you can leave, okay? You can leave. It's okay. You can go. Nah, I'm joking. Please don't go. Please don't go. That was rude. I apologize. But now watching this trailer and the poster and just seeing all the stuff that's coming, it really got me thinking about what I personally would like to see from this show. And there's so much. First and foremost, if you haven't seen my video on No Way Home and why I'm scared for that movie, go check that out. But this got me thinking, how about using this show as a way to do storylines that are being rumored for that movie in a smaller space? And yes, what I mean by that is give us a Daredevil Spider-Man story. Now granted, I don't know if maybe it's too much or maybe they wouldn't have the proper time to flesh out a storyline that takes the time to establish a character that we haven't gotten the MCU yet. For most people, maybe they don't know Daredevil like that too well. So maybe they don't want to do that if they don't have the time, but I still think there could be a really fun and just exciting storyline made out of those two characters, even going on one semi-medium-sized mission. And I really think that's something that they could explore there. And you don't have to put Charlie in the movie and have him lose his way in the I don't even know how to call. So maybe you put him here, you pair him with Tom Holland, you see how their voices and how their chemistry connects in even an animated space, and maybe you go, oh, this guy's ready. This guy's MCU ready. Print the contract. And they could even do a Daredevil storyline on its own. I don't know, but I would just love to see that character in What If, because if they're too scared or maybe not sure how to bring him into the live action MCU just yet, because there's a lot to do with that, maybe you try it here in a smaller space with less risks and then see how it goes. And yes, that'll absolutely lead me to my next point, which again, if you don't like it, you can leave. But the Defenders should absolutely get their own episode. I really do think that even for the people that aren't sure about the Netflix stuff because they haven't seen it or don't know about it, at least for the fans that do, and the fact that pretty much everyone knows Daredevil and you can get to know those characters through a decent amount of time, imagine being able to see them on just one moment and seeing maybe, oh, fans go, wow, you know, we didn't see these characters. Where are these characters? Can we get more of them? Let's put them live action. So maybe it's a really good breeding ground to try the Defenders here if you're not ready to put a team like the Fantastic Four into animated because you're still wondering about the live action. If you're wondering about putting some X-Men in the What If, you know, like if you're not ready to put them live action, some of you try What If. But if you're not even trying to do those guys yet, try somebody like the Defenders. I think they're such a good team. I think they'd make a great episode. You put them against the right villain and it's over. You have a smacker of an episode right there. Another idea I had is that I know we're getting Moon Knight, but an animated Moon Knight series with maybe a twist or another hero working with him, I think could be amazing as well. Not too long ago, Funko released a set of Funko Pops called the Infinity Warps, and it's a meshing of two characters, and they made something called the Arachnite, and it's Spider-Man in the Moon Knight costume, and it's all tattered and stuff. It's an amazing looking pop, and I thought, this is something that's cool for a pop because it's just a figure that people can find cool to look at. But imagine an episode like Spider-Man, you know, possibly becoming Moon Knight. I don't know, you know, I just thought that was a really cool look. It'd be a really interesting storyline to see fleshed out. I'm not sure if it's been done in the comic book, so I don't want to speak to that. But I just think, again, weird, crazy things like this is what a show like this should be built for. And I think a storyline like that with a character that we know and love, like Spider-Man, mixed with a character that we're getting fairly soon in Moon Knight, but just mixing those together and seeing what kind of crazy storyline you can come up with, I think that would be a really, really wicked episode. I'd also really like to see some characters make an appearance here that maybe got rumored around the MCU for a while, but didn't ever get a chance to be in a movie, get their own episode or at least team up here. Maybe something like Namor the Submariner. The last episode I think I'd like to see amongst the millions that I could probably come up with was one that as soon as I finished watching the trailer and seeing the poster for it, I came downstairs and I saw this and I was like, that'd be a fire episode. And it's these people right here. These two posters were gifts from my girlfriend some time ago, and ever since I got this one, it reignited my love for Black Panther and Storm as a power couple in comic books. And we know that it's happened before and only on the page. Why can't we see it in what would be an amazing episode of What If with that art style and seeing these two characters, one of which we haven't seen in the MCU yet and one of which we love in the MCU, come together and that'd be fire. Look, I already don't know how I'm gonna compose myself listening to Chadwick's voice as T'Challa in the Ravager episode. Man's wanted to cry during the trailer. But I know that this episode could still be amazing even if it's a different character in the Black Panther suit. I think seeing Black Panther and Storm as the rulers of Wakanda in even one episode, in one moment of conflict or struggle or whatever's going on, could be incredible in an animated series like this, especially with the way they'd make it look. So overall, we already know we're gonna get crazy heat from the first however many episodes we're getting right now, and we know that there is a thousand worlds of possibility for things that we can see coming from this series. But the reason I think overall this one is gonna be the best Disney Plus Marvel series put out is the fact that it's animated. From what I can see, it's pretty much general internet consensus among comic book, TV show, and movie watchers that DC has always put out the better animated content. Marvel obviously has some bangers, especially the retro bangers, but I think overall, movies and animated shows combined, DC is just way farther ahead. And that's not even to Marvel's discredit, it's just that DC has put some work into everything they've done animated wise. So I think this step into a really popular and like promoted series on Disney Plus, obviously being one of the biggest streaming services right now, that Marvel's really backing with a beautiful art style and a crazy concept and just twisting around stuff we already know. I think this has the potential to be Marvel's greatest animated achievement and really rival what DC's doing animated wise, because I don't know if we've ever seen a series like this. Sure, we've got TV shows and movies that have twisted something or maybe gone in a different direction than regular comic book lore, but to have every single episode a different storyline about a what-if question on an already existing character or scenario that could twist the entire fate of the universe, I think this is unprecedented. As soon as I saw this show announced amongst the rest of the Disney Plus Marvel stuff, I just knew it was going to be my favorite because I think this is something that has never been done before, and that Marvel now having a really solid foundation in a Marvel Cinematic Universe, they're going to kill this. I can just feel it in my bones. My initial impression of the very first trailer and visuals that we got was that this is a comic book come to life, and that's exactly what they want us to feel. Supporting that obviously with the actual voice cast of the people that we already know in these roles, and probably new people to come in that we're gonna fall in love with, even for just their singular episodes, I don't think you get much better than this. Look, we're almost done Loki. This video will come up before this. That's the end of this season. I thought Falcon and the Winter Soldier was excellent. WandaVision is still my favorite of all the three so far, but I think this one is going to surpass it off the first, even first two episodes of this show dropping. I know I'm going to be hooked, and I know that it's going to be something that as soon as this first season is done, I'm going to go more right now. Like, sometimes you need a break, or maybe it's cool to have a little bit of breathing time between seasons of stuff because, you know, it could end on a good cliffhanger that you want to set yourself up and build up excitement for, or maybe it was just a lot in that first season and you need to chill. But I think this is going to be one that, because everything's different and there's not going to be any continuation for these storylines, it's going to be like, I need more right now. Like run the content right now. So yeah, man, I'm just really excited for this. I know Marvel's gonna kill this one, and I know that this is gonna be an animated series for the ages, if I do wanna make a bold proclamation here. But I wanna know from y'all right now, how are y'all feeling about the new trailer for What If, about the What If concept and premise for this show in general? Are you guys excited for it? What are you most excited for? And maybe what do you wanna see as a storyline adapted in a What If mindset? Let me know all that down below. Can't wait to read what you guys are gonna say. And that's about it for this week. I'm patiently waiting for a month now for the premiere, and I will definitely make a video once the first season wraps up, which will obviously be a little ways away, but it's coming, and I already know it's gonna be a good review. But thank you guys so much for watching this video. Make sure you like the video if you liked it. Comment what I said below. Subscribe and hit the bell icon for notification on when stuff's gonna happen here. Quick plug before I wrap up this video. On July 12th, my boys Justin and Christian will be premiering their new podcast called Kicks on Stage that I was fortunate enough to direct and film. And I'm so excited to see the premiere. I'm so excited for what we have to show you guys. It's all about sneakers and dance and how those two worlds mesh, and all about the culture that's going on over there. They've done an excellent job. I can't wait to keep shooting the series with them and the podcast. It's incredible. So please make sure you guys hit the links that I have down below to follow them on social media, and also subscribe to the YouTube channel, because it's a visual podcast. You guys are gonna wanna see it July 12th. Don't miss it. Be there, be square, be fair. But of course, I really appreciate you guys watching this video. Stay tuned for the next ones. But as always, easy. You're my sugar, you're the sweet like Caroline. Baby, you're my breather, I will give you all my time.